Are you using Obsidian to build your second brain but worried about feeding your private notes to cloud AI? Or maybe you just want more control over your AI tools? What if I told you you could have a powerful AI assistant running directly inside Obsidian, completely free and 100% private? Your data never leaves your computer. Well, you absolutely can. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to set up Google's powerful Gemma 3 language model locally on your computer. This M1 Air handles it just fine. Connect it to Obsidian using a fantastic free plugin and unlock some seriously cool AI capabilities for your notes. No cloud required, no ongoing costs. Let's get this private AI brain built. Okay, first up, why bother with local AI? Three huge reasons. One, privacy. This is the big one. When you run an AI model locally, like we're about to do, your notes, your prompts, everything stays right here on your computer. It's not sent off to some company server. Peace of mind, right? Two, cost. These models like Gemma 3 we'll be using are open models. Free to download and run. Lamp Studio, the software we'll use, is also free. So, zero subscription fees. 3. Control and offline access. It works even if your internet is down. Plus, you have more control over the specific models and versions you use. We're using Gemma 3 today, developed by Google. Super capable and available in sizes that run even on hardware like an M1 Mac Air, compared to Cloud AI, where you're often renting access and trusting them with your data. This local approach puts you in the driver's seat. Let's get to the tools. First, head over to lmstudio.ai. Link in the description, of course. Download the version for your system. I'm grabbing the Mac Apple Silicon version. Once you open LM Studio, it looks something like this. Think of it as your command center for local AI models. The first thing we need is the actual AI brain, Gemma 3. Click on the search icon on the left, type Gemma 3, you'll see a bunch of options. Now, this is important. Models come in different sizes, parameters, and formats. For good performance on hardware like an M1 Mac Air, we want a smaller one. Specifically, we are looking for the Gemma 3 4B Instruct QAT model, ideally in the GGUF format, which runs easily. Find the specific version, check the file size fits your system, and hit download. This download might take a few minutes depending on the model size, so hang tight. Okay, once it's downloaded, you'll see it here in your downloaded models list. Step 1, complete. We have our AI brain. Easy, right? LM Studio makes finding and downloading these powerful models incredibly simple. Now, quickly, we need one more piece for the really smart stuff, like asking questions about your notes. It's called an embedding model. Think of it like this. The main AI, Gemma, is great at generating text, but to understand the meaning and relationships between your notes, you need this embedding model. It acts like a super librarian, reading your notes and organizing them based on their actual content, not just keywords. This allows the AI to find the relevant notes when you ask a question. Don't worry, it's simple to add in LM Studio. Go back to the search tab, search for a popular embedding model, something like Gnomic Embed Text is a great, efficient choice. Again, look for a GGUF version and download it. These are usually much smaller and faster to download. Boom! Embedding model acquired. Now we have both the brain and the librarian. Time to connect them to Obsidian. Okay, inside Obsidian, go to Settings, Community Plugins, Browse, search for Copilot, install it and make sure you enable it. Now, before we configure Copilot, we need to start the AI server in LM Studio and get the exact model names. Go back to LM Studio, enable developer mode and click terminal icon. Select the Gemma 3 for B instruct QAT model. You download it for the main LLM. Then also select the gnomic embed text or your chosen embedding model. In the embedding model section, if available here, or just make sure it's downloaded. Crucially, we need to enable cross-origin resource sharing or cores. Look for settings on this screen, find the checkbox that says enable cores, and make sure it's checked. This allows Obsidian to communicate with the server. Pay attention to the console logs or the model selection area. You need the exact identifier of the models being loaded. Copy the identifier for Gemma 3 model first. Back in Obsidian's Copilot settings, go to the models section, then chat model. Instead of picking a default, we'll add ours. Click add custom model. Give it a memorable display name, like local Gemma 3 for provider. Select LM Studio in the model name field. Paste the exact model identifier you copied from LM Studio. Click verify. If cores is enabled correctly and the server is running, you should get a success message. Once verified, click add model. Now select this newly added local Gemma 3 model from the main chat model drop-down list to make it the default. Great! Now repeat for the embedding model. Go back to LM Studio, copy the exact identifier for your embedding model. Back in Obsidian Copilot settings, go to models, then embedding models, click add custom model, give it a name like local embeddings, select LM Studio as the provider, paste the model identifier into the model name field, click verify and then add model. Finally, select your newly added model from the main embedding models drop-down list. Okay, that was a bit more involved, but by adding them as custom models, we ensure Obsidian Copilot knows exactly which local models to talk to. You are now fully set up with a private chat and embedding capability. Alright, the moment of truth. Let's see this in action. You'll now notice a new chat icon in your left sidebar in Obsidian. That's your Copilot chat interface. Let's open the chat and just ask Gemma 3 a general question. Explain the concept of local LLMs briefly. And there it goes, generating the answer locally. Fantastic! Now for the integrated features. Here is a long note I took. I'll just select the text, right click, find Copilot summarize section. Give it a second. And there we go! Summary generated by our local Gemma 3. Now for the embeddings magic. Let's ask Copilot a question that requires info from multiple nodes. I choose Vault QA and ask this question. It uses the local gnomic embed text model to find relevant nodes and then local Gemma 3 to generate the answer. Look at that! Pulled info locally. This is incredibly powerful for knowledge discovery. You can customize the default prompts in the Copilot settings too. Play around with it. This setup gives you a truly private, powerful and free AI assistant woven directly into your Obsidian workflow. Imagine the possibilities. Thank you for watching.